Hey, thanks for watching this review. Before we get started, if you're trying to choose the best surf skate for you, then I invite you to get my ultimate surf skate selector at surfskate.love. The surf skate selector includes over 100 models from the top 10 surf skate trucks, including Akilo, Carver C7 and CX, Kerfboard, Slide, Smooth Star, Spice Skate, Swell Tech, Waterborne, and Yao. All you have to do is answer 8 quick questions and the surf skate selector automatically eliminates every model that doesn't meet your specifications and gives you a very small list of only the very best surf skate models for you. So click the link in the video description below to get the ultimate surf skate selector now. So today we are reviewing the Slide, and I've got 5 Slide models here: the CMC Performance, the Diamond Carving model, the Gussie model, the Vahine, and the Neem Pro, and I'll go into detail on all of those models. Now here are the points that we'll cover in this review. First and foremost, we'll go into who and what slides are best used for. Next, I'll go into the Slide truck itself and how it's built, functions, and performs. Then I'll go into detail on all of these models to help you choose between the models. Then I'll go into pros and cons of the Slide. And then finally, to finish up, I've got a treat for you. As you know, I am not the best rider, and so to compensate for that, I hired my friend Joey Daly, who's one of the best surf skaters I've ever seen, from Oceanside, California, to drive up to Utah to spend a week with me to ride all of my surf skates. And so at the end of this review, after my review, you're going to get Joey Daly's take on the Slide, and so Joey can push these boards to their full capabilities in a way that I can't and add a lot of depth to this review. So who and what is the Slide best used for? Well, after investing over $16,000 on more than 60 surf skates to date, and that includes 28 different surf skate trucks, I've identified what I believe to be the top 10 surf skate trucks in the world, and these are Swell Tech, Kerfboard, Smooth Star Thruster, Akilo, Spice Skate, Yao Meraki, Carver C7, Waterborne Surf Adapter, Carver CX, and Slide. And I've arranged these in order on a scale of what I call pure surf trainers on this side of the scale, down to street cruisers on the other side of the scale. I am not a surfer, so I cannot tell you which of these trucks best replicate surfing, and I can't make any commentary on these trucks as relates to surfing. However, I can explain to you the measurable properties of these trucks. On this side of the scale, the further left you are on the scale, the properties of these trucks are: number one, they have smoother, looser, more fluid trucks. That makes them very responsive to upper body movements, which, as I understand it, is great for technical surfing training. Because these trucks are so loose and fluid, it means that when you pump them, they generate more lateral side-to-side motion, with your front foot kind of going side-to-side, as opposed to pulling you forward with forward momentum like the street cruisers do. And that means that the trucks on this side of the scale are best used in small areas, flat surfaces, and for shorter distances. So if you're doing like technical surf training using cones on a tennis court, these trucks are great for that. On the other side of the scale, for these street cruisers, the characteristics of these are the trucks feel tighter and snappier, and that means that when I pump these trucks like the CX and the Slide, I will tend to use more lower body movements as opposed to upper body movements like these other ones on the left side. Things like using your ankles and your knees more. And when you pump these street cruisers, they generate more forward momentum, and that means that they're more versatile. You can go for longer distances over a wide variety of terrain, and you can just do more with these street cruisers. It does not mean that you cannot do pure surf training on these street cruisers. It simply means that these street cruisers I find to be more versatile than the pure surf trainers. But I think that you will find a lot of surfers who like these street cruisers, like the CX and the Slide, for surf training. They work great for that as well. So in that context, I put Slide on the furthest side of the scale, on the street cruiser side, next to the Carver CX. So I place these 5, Swell Tech, Kerfboard, Smooth Star Thruster, Akilo, and Spice Skate, in the category of pure surf trainer. And then these 3, Yao Meraki, Carver C7, and Waterborne, I put in the category as of hybrids, by which I mean they can do it all. They have the characteristics of the pure surf trainers. They also have the characteristics of the street cruisers. And the main difference is that they have more forward momentum than the surf trainers, which means that they're better for a wider variety of applications. And then over here, we've got the Carver CX and the Slide that I'm characterizing as the street cruisers. And so what that means for me is that if you are a surfer however, I probably am not going to recommend the Slide to you as the best surf trainer. Although it does work for that, I think that if that's what you're looking for, you're probably better off with something else. However, if you're a non-surfer like me, I think that the Slide is one of your best options, especially if you are a beginner rider and especially if you're just getting started out in surf skating. So I think that the people who the Slide are most suited for are beginner street cruisers who want a versatile board that can do a lot of things, but probably is not more weighted towards that pure surf training truck. The Slide truck is a really unique design. When you look at some of these other designs, you have, this is the C7. The C7 is what's called a dual axis system. And what that means is it has two dimensions of motion. So first of all, it has this rotation here. And then secondly, it's got this adjustment here that creates the lean on that axle. The Slide is the same as the CX in that it is a single axis system in that it only has one axis of rotation right there. The CX is the same way, it's just the one axis of rotation. But you can see how that just, you've got a spring inside here and you have an adjustment nut right here. While we're on that, technically the Slide truck is adjustable, and I'm gonna go into further detail on this when I open this up for you. But my advice on the Slide is to take this as loose as possible and then to never touch this spring. The reason being is because you don't have like the widest range of motion on this Slide already. And when you tighten this up, you can get this so tight to where it really is acting almost like kind of like a longboard truck where it's very tight. You lose the surf skate pump feel. And the second thing is these are not the highest quality parts. And I have broken a spring in a Slide, and that's very common actually, by over tightening it. You want it as loose as possible anyway. So when it comes to adjusting this nut on the Slide, just take it to where the nut is flush on that bolt to where it's as wide as possible, and then just leave it alone. One advantage to the Slide truck is that it is the lowest to the ground of any other surf skate truck. Curfboard can actually make that claim, but only if you eliminate their risers. So if you eliminate their risers on the Curfboard, this technically is lower to the ground than the Slide. However, when you eliminate those risers, you also eliminate the lean. Now for me personally, that's not a huge advantage, but I can see it being an advantage for people, especially if you're like coming from a street skating background like Mark the Landlocked Surfer. I can see that you would have a lot of versatility on the Slide that you don't have on some of these other trucks, because maybe you can do some more traditional street skating type maneuvers that you can on the Slide. Now, as far as how the Slide feels and functions, if you're a non-surfer, then that means that I'm going to say really the only trucks that you should be considering at least for your first or second buy are going to be like from the Yao Meraki on down this way. So the Meraki, the Carver C7, the Waterborne Surf Adapter, and the CX and the Slide. And of these five, I think that the one you're going to compare it most to is probably the Carver CX, because that's the other kind of street cruiser. I much prefer the Carver CX over the Slide. I do like the Slide, but I like the CX for a number of reasons. Number one, I just think it feels better. Number two, I think it's less maintenance because it's bushings and not the spring. And so you have higher potential for breakages on the Slide truck as opposed to the CX truck. You also get higher rail to rail lean out of the CX as opposed to the Slide. You don't get a lot of rail to rail lean on the Slide. So personally, I go with the CX over the Slide, but there are a lot of people who really like the Slide. And maybe I think there's even some people out there who maybe even prefer the Slide over the CX or maybe even the Carver C7. But the main advantage to me of the Slide over a Carver is the price. So at the time of this review, you're going to pay about $220 for a Slide, and for a Carver CX, you're going to pay $250, you're going to pay $265 for a Carver C7. I call the Slide the budget street cruiser for beginners, and that is not to reduce it or pigeonhole it into that niche, but rather to just kind of, for me, that's highlighting its main advantages. So if you are a non-surfer beginner to surf skating, to me, honestly, of all of these trucks, the Carver CX and the Slide are probably the top two that I'm going to would have you consider. I liked Slide a lot better when they were priced at $199. Over the last year, they've gone from that $199 to that $219, $220 range. I think they can justify it, but I think that that's honestly pushing it just a bit. For me personally, like the real sweet spot of the Slide would be $199, and I think that that would really like highlight its advantage over Carver that much more. But having said that, I do think that a slide is worth 220. For me, it's just all about that context and that comparison of 220 for a slide versus 250 for a Carver. For my money, I'm going with the Carver CX, but that's just personal preference. All right, now I want to show you inside this slide truck, show you how it works. And we don't really even need to take this apart because I can just visually show you inside this and you can see how it works. So come up close here and you can see how what we have here is a spring inside that attaches to your swivel arm right in there. And you can see how that's going to go side to side like so. And right here we have the ability to tighten or loosen this spring. You're going to see that when we tighten this up, what it's going to do is basically pull this spring closer together. Okay, so you can see how that's working. But here's the thing. Do not mess around with the slide spring because these are actually fairly easy to break. I've broken one myself. Even though it's adjustable, my advice is to just loosen this up as much as possible. I'm going to take this back and we'll have basically that nut flush here. And then just leave this spring alone and don't mess around with the slide. Having shown you how to adjust that and how it adjusts, I'm going to go ahead and back this off. We're gonna just run this as loose as possible. You wanna have that lock nut engaged there, otherwise that can slide off. So I'm gonna go ahead and take that back on just a little bit more. But when I ride a slide, that's exactly how I want it. I want that nut to be flush with that bolt, which means it's as loose as possible. That gives me the freest range of motion as possible, and it will prevent any issues with that spring from over-tightening. That's how you'll break that spring, is basically over-tightening it and then running it too tight, and then when you pump and carve it too hard, you're going to put a lot more tension on that spring. Now let's go into the slide models. Now, if you go to the slide website, it looks a little bit confusing. It looks like they have more models than they actually do, but I've got the five models here, and really this is pretty much their lineup. They have a couple other, they have a quad and sunset models, but those have kind of similar dimensions to some of these other ones up here anyway. They really just have color variations within these different models. So here we've got the CMC Performance model, the Diamond Carving model, the Gussie model, the Vahine model, and the Neem Pro. Let's just talk about these one at a time. Starting with the CMC Performance. I'm honestly not sure why they call it the Performance model. Neither me nor Joey were a big fan of this model. It's just kind of like a pretty flat deck. This model honestly feels kind of like a kid's toy. Like this was just not a super high performance model for either of us, so I'm not sure why they call it a performance model. And it's kind of a narrower wheelbase, I think, is kind of the difference on that, which doesn't make for the best flow on your pumping. My favorite model of all of them is the Diamond Carving. The decks look fairly similar. I think you have a little bit of a wider wheelbase on this. There's just something about this Diamond model. I think you have a better, little bit of a kicktail. This just feels better. This is what I would call the slide sports car model, and of all of their models, it's probably the one that I would most recommend to the most riders. Next, we have this Gussie model, and as you can see, what sets the Gussie model apart is that it has a very wide deck. So this is just a really big platform. I like this deck a lot. It's got good concave. It's got great foot placement for both your front and your back foot. However, I personally find that the width on this to be just a little bit too much. I don't think you need this width, and I think that the Diamond Carving model gives you everything you need with not as much bulk on this deck. Next, we have the Swallow model. This is 32 inches long with an 18 inch wheelbase. It's called the Swallow model because it has this swallow tail. Now, personally, I'm not a big fan of these swallow tails. You might also hear them called fish tails. I don't like the foot placement on these personally. I just don't think that you have a good wide space for your foot, but you don't have to put your foot on right there on this one. You can put your foot anywhere in here and it's going to ride just fine. So you have fine foot placement on this. That's just a personal preference. This is what I would call their cruising sedan model. So if you want more of like a longer distance cruiser, if you're a little bit taller, you have a little bit wider stance like me, and you want a longer distance cruiser, then you're going to want to go with the Swallow model over, say, that more nimble sports car model of the Diamond Carving model. The two biggest models that I would recommend to the most people in slide are the Diamond Carving sports car model and the Swallow cruising sedan model right here. And then finally, we have have their Neem Pro model. This is their longest model at 35 inches. This would be like their, if you're like a longboard surfer and you want to practice a lot of cross-stepping, or you want real long distance cruising, this would be the model that that's intended for. I'll just bottom line the Neem Pro for you. I am not a fan of this model, and I'll tell you why. This was a discovery for me. I found that the wheelbase on this is too wide for this slide truck. I don't think it creates optimal pumping. I think that all of these surf skate trucks have kind of a optimal wheelbase range for them. And when I got onto this, the pumping motion of it is just not great. But after riding all these models, that's my take on the Neem Pro. And personally, I think if you want a little bit of a longer model, go with that Swallow model over the Neem Pro. Pros and cons of the slide. Well, the first pro that I would say is that, number one, it's just a great functional and great feeling surf skate truck. It can do anything you want it to do. It can do pure surf training, it can do the street cruising thing. It may not be the best performer in any one given category, but it can do it all. And that's the second thing that I would say about the slide, is that it is very versatile. The fact that it is low to the ground, the fact that it is a great long distance pumper, you get a lot of forward momentum out of it. That makes it versatile. It means you can use it for a wide variety of applications. It's not just limited to that pure surf trainer. The next pro I would say is that the truck is very stable, which makes it great for beginners. It's a really great beginner option. And then the final advantage that I would say to the slide is that it's the cheapest complete surf skate system that you see of the lineup back here. And so, as I said, that just makes it a great budget option for beginners getting into surf skating. Now, the cons for the slide are, first and foremost, you just don't get the widest range of motion and the best feel out of it. I personally prefer the Carver CX, the Carver C7, and the Yao Muraki over the slide, but that is just pure personal preference. You'd have to try them all to try for yourself. The next con for me is that the slide isn't the highest quality component parts, and so they're not going to take a beating as much as say a Carver, but that's fine because it's compensated in the price. And so that is my take on the slide, and with all that said, let's hear what Joey Daly has to hear about the slide. What would you use the slide truck for? Is this a pure surf trainer? Is it a pure street cruiser? Or is it a hybrid that you could do everything with?
My honest opinion, I believe it's like a street cruiser. However, you can get some adaptability out of the truck.
You could use this for surf training, is that what you're saying?
Yeah. Yeah.
So you could use it, but would you use it for surf training in context of all these other options?
If I was looking for like a specific surf training, it wouldn't be with these options. However, if I had never ridden another surf skate before, these options would be very, very good. They are not the best. However, they do give you the ability to just cruise or get surf training in if you prefer.
Talk to me about how you think the slide truck compares to the Carver CX and the Carver C7, because I know that you're a Carver guy.
I mean, I'm always going to go with Carver just because I feel like Carver has the best mobility, the best adaptability, and the easiest to maintain. The slides are very great. However, I feel there's some lack of communication sometimes between the front truck and repositioning. Sometimes when you're doing big carves, you can feel a catch in the front truck here and there. And I feel like it just doesn't have much rail-to-rail lean or open space to use the front truck before it hits the metal.
One of the aspects of the slide truck is that along with the kerf board and the slide are the surf skate trucks that are the lowest to the ground. Do you find that to be an advantage? If so, why or why not?
I guess it does give small advantages here and there. It gives you more stability.
Okay, so you talk about stability, Joey. Does that mean that you would recommend the slide for beginners?
Yeah, it's definitely anywhere from beginner to advanced even. I feel like they'd be comfortable on the slide truck.
If you are an advanced rider, do you think that the slide is going to be your first choice? We've all seen you ride it, so we know that you can get a lot of performance out of the slide, but is it what you're going to choose?
No, it's definitely not going to be my go-to. My go-to will always be either Carver CX or Carver C7. However, it does give you, if you've never ridden a surf skate before and you want an affordable model, slide does provide that.
Of these decks and these models, Joey, which do you like best and why?
My honest opinion, the diamond carving model is preferably my favorite just because it gives me the closest replication to a Carver CX. It gives me that whippy and tight, like little turn radius. It gives me the ability to whip around, spin, and all that.
What was your take on this CMC Pro model?
I feel like the model's a little overrated. I feel like it could have used a little more work. It just feels kind of boxy, a little bit weird with the design. I didn't like how they had the flat area here. You can see that there's the slightest amount of concave, but without the concave, it kind of loses the grip you would need in big carves, big turns.
I like the Gussie model because I have a size 11 shoe, so I think that it's good for people with bigger feet.
Yeah.
But you did not like the width of the Gussie model, correct?
That's true, not in my opinion. I didn't like the width to wheelbase ratio. I feel like I couldn't get the proper drive or the proper pump that I was looking for out of it.
And what was your take on this Swallow model? It's longer. You don't really have a kick tail.
I honestly believe that this slide kind of gives you a longboard feel. Like, you can kind of do more action. You have a lot of foot space. It's not too wide to where you're overabundant on space. And the wheel width is really nice to where you can kind of just walk around, ride it like it's a longboard, do like little hang fives. You can get back on the tail, kind of whip it around back and forth.
So this is more of your cruiser longboard model where you're going to kind of just be moving around a lot on it.
Yeah.
But not locked in.
I like the Neem Pro. However, I feel like it's just a little bit too long. It does give you that like longboardy surfy feel, but you kind of lose it once you get towards the middle area here. If you're not on the tail or near the front, kind of surfing, you lose a lot of the capabilities. It's not a bad cruiser. If you're trying to get point A to point B with some nice little carves in between, it'll definitely get that done for you.
I want to get your take on the wheels, because anybody who watches you ride knows that you utilize the full capabilities of wheels. You do tons of snaps and slides, and so you need a very versatile wheel. I personally feel like the slide wheels are very great for your style of riding. What's your take?
Yeah, I like them a lot. They have the grip when you need them, but they also release as soon as you need them as well. So they have that like good hybrid feel of not being too grippy, but they also give you the capabilities of releasing if you need.